It looks like Starship is ready to make a major announcement, and there is real excitement around the world to watch the moment unfold. As interest reaches fever pitch, Musk announced a significant shift in strategy, providing a key update on the upcoming development phase. What did he say? And how is SpaceX preparing for the challenges ahead? Let's dive deeper into today's episode of NR Studio. Right now, we're anxiously anticipating the upcoming Starship Flight 9, a mission that includes some of the most ambitious goals ever set in the program's history. Among these goals, the primary objective is to successfully land both stages, with a particular focus on landing the ship in the ocean. In addition to simply landing in the ocean, the ship is required to accomplish a series of important objectives. These include successfully reaching orbit, releasing its payload, performing an engine restart in the vacuum of space, and surviving a controlled re-entry through Earth's atmosphere. However, each of these objectives serves as a significant stepping stone toward a truly revolutionary achievement. Capturing a spacecraft with the Mechazilla launch tower arm, this milestone marks a significant leap forward for SpaceX in its quest for full rocket reusability, a transformative breakthrough in spaceflight technology. If successful, it would mark the first instance of a spacecraft being captured of this magnitude, as opposed to traditional methods such as landing on feet or landing on legs. This innovative approach could significantly reduce the turnaround time and cost of repairs. Elon Musk has indicated that SpaceX would need to successfully conduct at least one additional ocean landing from their ship before attempting the complex tower capture maneuver. Until now, he has not provided a firm timeline. In a recent announcement, Musk indicated that later this year, if circumstances were in SpaceX's favor, the spacecraft could be captured by the launch tower in a manner similar to a booster capture. This statement carries a lot of weight for a few reasons. Initially, it presented a more firm timeline, suggesting that the tower capture could potentially occur sometime after mid-2025. This timeline came as a surprise to many fans and analysts, including myself, who had anticipated the event earlier. For example, I had anticipated the capture attempt would occur during Flight 10, assuming Flight 9 was successful. Musk's latest timeline suggests that the company is adopting a more deliberate and deliberate strategy moving forward. Second, it's important to highlight how Musk manages expectations by using the phrase, "if fate wills," in reference to SpaceX. This remarkably humble tone demonstrates a pragmatic awareness of the hurdles ahead. Given the technical challenges faced during the flight earlier this year, it seems that SpaceX is placing more emphasis on ensuring reliability than on expediting its operations. Taking the extra time to ensure that the vehicle operates without issue is a wise decision. This careful preparation will play a critical role in ensuring the success and safety of any future capture attempts. Musk's tone reflects important insights into his development as a leader. Known for setting bold and sometimes over-the-top goals in previous endeavors, this new, more pragmatic strategy reflects a more mature outlook. This suggests that he has strong confidence in his team, while also being well aware of the significant complexities involved in their goal. By examining the flight schedule and considering SpaceX's current rate of about one launch every month or two, we can begin to determine a potential timeframe for when a tower capture attempt could be attempted. A reasonable timeframe for the arrival of Flight 12 or 14 could be expected. Flight 13 is anticipated to showcase the S-39 and B-18 prototypes, which are expected to be early models of Starship's enhanced V-3 series. Given that this is a significant hardware upgrade, it is unlikely that SpaceX would risk attempting a tower capture during its maiden flight. Flight 12 is anticipated to use the S-38 and B-15 vehicles, which are based on the established V-2 and V-1 designs. These options have undergone extensive testing and refinement, positioning them as strong contenders for attempting high-risk maneuvers, such as Mechazilla capture. Flight 14 deserves attention, especially if it is the second mission to use V-3 hardware. At that point, SpaceX will have gained critical data from Flight 13, which could improve the safety and decision-making process, making the attempt to capture the rocket more informed and safe. It's important to note that this timeline is hypothetical, and actual outcomes will depend largely on how future flights go. If all goes well, we could potentially see a momentous event as Starship is captured by Mechazilla before the end of this year. What do you think? Which flight do you think will be the first to attempt to capture the ship? We invite you to share your predictions in the comments section. After a thorough evaluation of the timing surrounding the first attempt to capture Starship's upper stage, a critical question arises. What is SpaceX's goal with this bold maneuver? In his latest tweet, Elon Musk provided a definitive response, stating that SpaceX intends to capture the spacecraft using a launch tower, which mirrors the method used for boosters. While this statement may seem simple at first glance, it has significant technical and engineering implications. SpaceX has already demonstrated impressive accomplishments in landing their Super Heavy boosters, most notably with Booster 14 during Flight 7 and Booster 15 during Flight 8. Both landings were distinguished by their remarkable smoothness and precision. These missions have demonstrated that the company is quickly becoming adept at first-stage capture techniques. Securing a place on the ship presents an even greater challenge. Unlike boosters, the spacecraft is designed for full orbital capabilities and is equipped with sophisticated, highly sensitive systems. These include features such as aerodynamic flaps and tiles that can withstand extreme heat. These components are needed to survive the much more demanding journey while ensuring flawless performance throughout each phase of the mission. The first step involves the orbital insertion process. Before the spacecraft can even consider returning, it must first reach orbit, a feat that has posed significant challenges in recent missions. To accomplish this, it is essential to ensure optimal engine functionality, along with a fully operational heat shield that can withstand the immense pressures experienced during ascent. After reaching orbit, the spacecraft is expected to perform a series of tasks, including deploying its payload and reigniting its engines. While these elements may have been lacking or neglected during the initial capture attempt, they are critical to Starship's long-term goals, including satellite deployment and prospective missions beyond our planet. Next comes the re-entry phase, often considered the most dangerous. The spacecraft must be able to withstand temperatures exceeding 1,500 degrees Celsius. Flaps play a critical role in managing the spacecraft's precise orientation and velocity, while heat shields are essential to preventing catastrophic failure. After the intense and fiery descent, the spacecraft must still achieve the proper alignment for a successful landing. Finally, we come to the Mechazilla capture, which is the most daring step of all. However, despite the success of all other aspects, the task of capturing the spacecraft using the Mechazilla tower arm presents significant challenges. The spacecraft's unique design, weight distribution, and flight trajectory add considerable complexity to the process, making it far more challenging than simply capturing a booster. No other space agency has ever done something like this before. To effectively capture the Starship upper stage, often referred to as the ship, using Mechazilla, SpaceX faces the need to undertake substantial technical, logistical, and strategic preparation in the coming months. Achieving success on this initial attempt would mark a breakthrough moment in the annals of aerospace history, moving the company closer to its goal of complete rocket reusability. A critical early step is to engage in planning. SpaceX is tasked with deciding which upcoming flight will serve as the inaugural attempt to capture a ship. This choice is important not only for the preparations associated with the mission at hand, but also for its significance in relation to the anticipated transition to future Starship iterations, including V3. Understanding which specific prototype will be used allows for more precise testing, improved system optimization, and improved predictability of the project's schedule. Meanwhile, future Starship missions, particularly flights 9 through 11, are critical to future development. These missions are required to demonstrate ever-increasing levels of reliability and capability. Flight 9 faces significant pressure to overcome the issues that arose during Flights 7 and 8. This involves achieving orbit, launching a payload, and successfully reigniting the spacecraft's engines while in space. The following procedures are essential to verifying Starship's orbital capabilities. Perhaps even more important is the spacecraft's ability to withstand re-entry. Flight 9 is required to demonstrate improved survivability of its heat shield and improved control of its aerodynamic flaps under the challenging conditions of re-entry, characterized by extreme heat and pressure. If the spacecraft demonstrates the proper capabilities during the steady descent and deceleration maneuvers, it will demonstrate that the system is approaching the level of accuracy required for a successful Mechazilla capture. In the optimal scenario, Flight 9 successfully meets all of these objectives. If not, Flights 10 and 11 will provide further opportunities to improve these skills. The series of successive test flights serve as an important foundation for the ground-based effort to capture the spacecraft mid-flight. In addition to ensuring validation of the flight procedures, it is critical that the ground systems are also well prepared. The capture tower on Pad B has been successfully constructed and has undergone testing that includes motion and load simulations. The Mechazilla arms have successfully demonstrated their ability to capture and stack the boosters, indicating that they are mechanically prepared for the upcoming phase. To successfully capture the craft, SpaceX is carefully coordinating all elements of the system to function together smoothly. Recent progress has seen the successful relocation of the orbital launch cradle to Pad B, where it has been elevated and securely welded into place. Following the integration of these final structural elements, SpaceX will proceed with a thorough inspection of each system, then conduct a comprehensive full system integration test. With the planned capture attempt set for later this year, the company has significant opportunity to refine and validate all aspects of the launch and recovery system. It is important to note that Pad B could be involved in flight as soon as Flight 11. This will provide critical information and further confirm the readiness of the pad before engaging in the more complex responsibilities of capturing the craft. As SpaceX looks to the future, a complete transition to the V3 prototype could require further modifications to its launch infrastructure. This could require adjustments to Pad A and Pad B, including raising the tower to better serve the taller vehicle, or the construction of an entirely new facility. There are signs that Pad A will soon be taken offline for repairs, signaling significant changes to come. This transition phase is heavily influenced by capabilities related to production and testing. SpaceX is rapidly expanding its manufacturing capabilities with significant upgrades to the Star Factory, as well as the upcoming Gigabyte Complex. These advancements are focused on accelerating production and rapidly incorporating the latest advances in vehicle technology. We may get more insight in the near future at the upcoming Starbase company discussion. Elon Musk has indicated that the primary emphasis will be on Mars-related aspirations. However, it is anticipated that he will also discuss the important initial steps needed to achieve this goal. This includes outlining a strategy for spacecraft capture, which is a critical step in facilitating effective spaceflight missions. In conclusion, the next few months will be crucial for SpaceX. With careful planning, successful test flights, robust ground systems, and increased production, the ambitious goal of capturing the Starship upper stage could potentially be realized by the end of the year. Successfully capturing the spacecraft with Mechazilla is not only a significant technical achievement, but also a watershed moment in engineering progress. It is a significant milestone in paving the way for the next phase of space exploration. SpaceFeet supports a variety of bold missions that aim to extend Starship's capabilities far beyond existing limitations. The highly anticipated orbital refueling test has finally arrived, a critical step toward enabling future missions to the Moon and Mars. Originally anticipated for release later this year, the schedule may now be pushed back to early next year. A successful capture by Mechazilla could instill the confidence and operational readiness needed for these complex maneuvers in orbit. SpaceX is set to turn its attention to lunar exploration, with plans for an uncrewed Starship lunar lander slated to launch as early as next year. The initiative will lay the groundwork for the crewed Artemis missions planned for 2027 and 2028, which will mark humanity's return to the Moon after a hiatus of more than 5 decades. In line with its ambitious goals, SpaceX is making significant strides toward Mars exploration. The company intends to launch an uncrewed mission in the next 2 years, followed by a potential crewed flight planned for 2 years after that. Achieving this ambitious goal ultimately hinges on mastering a critical skill, the ability to execute a reliable landing. In space exploration, precision landings play a critical role in everything from returning boosters to Earth to landing missions on the Moon and Mars. The ability to prepare a vehicle for reusability depends heavily on the accuracy of these landings. The Mechazilla capture serves as a definitive assessment of that capability. This transformation requires flawless navigation, sophisticated software systems, a mechanical arm, and instantaneous coordination. If SpaceX achieves its goal, it could revolutionize the concept of reusability in space travel. The innovation has the potential to dramatically reduce costs, speed up the launch process, and make Starship missions as commonplace as commercial airline flights. SpaceX's hint of a potential capture attempt later this year adds significant weight to the occasion. In a matter of months, we could see Starship re-enter orbit, potentially captured mid-air by a sophisticated robotic arm. It's a bold step into the future. It's not focused on just one goal. It marks the beginning of lunar exploration, missions to Mars, and regular access to space. Getting a place on the ship validates the reality of our vision, showing that the future is closer than we could have anticipated. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next episode, and thank you for your support.